of unstoppable greatness, understanding the reality of unstoppable greatness. Part 6, understanding the reality of unstoppable greatness. God has helped me to bring you points, under points. We have major 4 points that have been given by God. We are going to start from point number 5 because of our time. The catalyst to unstoppable greatness. Somebody praise God. If you are in the house, shout, I am here for Christ. The catalyst that activates the covenant of greatness. The catalyst that activates the covenant of greatness. The catalyst that activates the covenant of greatness. I've given you 4 points, and today we are starting by 5 points. And the word is God. You activate greatness by God. Hallelujah. Joy possesses greatness. And greatness unstoppable is our heritage in Christ. Joy possesses greatness. And greatness unstoppable is our heritage in Christ. That is, we are divinely redeemed for divine greatness. We are divinely redeemed for divine greatness. Listen, I'm going to be fast a few more times. Jeremiah 29, verse 11. We are divinely redeemed for divine greatness. I decree to somebody's life, everything about you will be great before you leave this place. Jeremiah 29, verse 11. Jeremiah 29, verse 11. Yes. Jeremiah 29, verse 11. Glory to God. For I know the thought that I think towards you, said the Lord, thought of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected hand. You are divinely redeemed to be great from the beginning and to hand as well in greatness. And this kind of greatness is not the greatness that can be cut short by any power. It's not a greatness that any power can terminate. We are redeemed from the beginning. You enter into God's greatness and end in greatness. And such a greatness that has no sorrow, a greatness that will give you peace. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. There are types of greatness and types of peace. The Bible says, my peace have I given unto you, not like the one that the world is giving. So greatness that comes from God is different from greatness that will come from any other Satan. Or any Satan, sorry. The greatness that you get from Satan guarantees no peace. But the greatness that comes from God gives you peace. So the greatness involves peace. When you sleep without thinking. You are not afraid of anything. So you are not waiting to do anything 3 months, 1 year, or 2 years. No. You don't sacrifice anything on any evil altar because it comes from God's altar. Anything that comes from God is accomplished with peace of mind. So one of the ways you have assurance that what the Lord is doing to you is from the Lord. One of the things is the peace of mind. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because of our time, joy is a spiritual attitude to weariness. What do you mean by somebody is being weary? When you are extreme tired, or extreme tiredness. You are disfocused. You are tired not to press further. So, ability not to do for that thing. Hallelujah. Joy is a spiritual attitude to wins. Meaning, joy is a solution to wins. Where you see joy, you don't see weariness yet. Hallelujah. Weariness is a weapon in the hands of Satan to put people in perpetual bondage. Weariness is a weapon in the hand of Satan to put people in perpetual bondage. So I said, it means as you become extreme tired. So you give up over goofing. Because maybe of challenges, Bishop Abiy said, adverse. He said, when adverse situation press on you, it's a platform for advancement. Say, because adversity leads to advancement. Whatever you are doing and the load is look so heavy, I used to tell people, anything that Satan will not discourage you is not genuine.
Yes, sir.
Yes. To know that you are on the right channel, on the right place, you will be discouraged. Because Satan will not want the joy to flow. Satan will not want peace to come. He knows how to do something. Satan didn't just carry people from back. He maneuver. He lure you. You will be the one by yourself that will say, I know they do again. You will be the one by yourself that say, I know. So, hence you disfocus. You are out of the channel. And God bring you to somewhere here. So weariness, when you understand the spiritual thing and you know how to succeed. See, God will not give you money. You can't wake up and find money on top of your bed. It's not a magician. It gives you idea to be great. It teaches you, it gives you. I told somebody else in real estate on the school, the greatness is in us. Everybody sitting and hearing me, you carry money. I want to rush before, but let me explain this to you. Everybody sitting now, you carry greatness. Everybody sitting now, you carry money inside you. House, your house, inside you. Your car, everything you want to become is you. Your vision is you. So, what to see? What happened to the baby? Before a baby comes, it comes through the womb. So you are a pregnant of greatness. To see the greatness, you have to put to bed. That's why he said, someone in the book of Isaiah 48 said, I give you idea to be great. So your talent, your spiritual gift, your energy, so are the ingredients in you that will open door for the greatness to manifest. And that is why it's too dangerous and extremely dangerous for Christians to be lazy. For nothing can come out of you when you are very lazy. Your future, you have to work it out. So the only one of the problem of African people is we don't work, but we pray. We are generating power. You can be powerful and be poor.
Yes, sir.
Because you don't work. So you become wealthy by working. You generate power by praying. Because I don't know that greatness, the seed of greatness has been sown in the life of everyone. And when you are highly disfocused, you can't know the right thing to do. Ask question. Anybody that is focused on thinking does not know the next step. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Oh, no.
Yes, sir.
Am I correct?
Yes,
They like peace of mind because God speaks through peace. I mean, in peace. When you are, when you are settled, if you want to talk to me, say, isolate yourself. You want to see? When your mind is full of trouble, full of trouble, you may not hear God. When willingness takes over your heart, you are left with human calculation. Then you want to live under law. You can calculate well, you can calculate strongly. But not all your own way that pleases God. Not all your desire that pleases God. And that is why you must learn to leave God to do the way you want to do it. You must leave you up for God to do it the way you want to do it. And that is why it's so dangerous if you cannot think well. One of the tragedies that will happen to a Christian in life is not Satan. It's when you cannot reason. When you are dead, physically, your brain is dead. Then, something disastrous has happened to you. Hallelujah. Willingness is a weapon in the hand of Satan to keep the people of God into bondage. That is one of the ways Satan arrests his victim. And in a place you see willingness, you don't see God. Am I taking much of your time now? Hallelujah. Nothing works where God is lacking. Catalysts that activate the covenant of greatness. That's what we are talking. So please, let me talk to you. I'll take you to scripture. Nothing works where joy is lacking. Where there is willingness, you see depression. If you are sitting here, say, I am here in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Give God a shout of praise. I will beg you to listen to this few points, even if it's only this point I'm going to give for today. I mean, you're supposed to be shocked when I said, nothing will work where joy is lacking. A lot of you don't know what how important joy is. So you can see there are many things responsible for your breakthrough that is used to come. Many, many things. But when you focus on fall down, it's very good. Every Christian knows that you must continually checkmate yourself. Nothing works where joy is lacking. Devil will do everything possible to make sure that you don't have joy. But then understand that where there is no joy of God, miracle is lacking. Willingness is a platform where Satan put people down. There are a lot of things in the world that kill people, not only sickness. Willingness is a killer. Because by the time you think that compact, that will drop, you just be focused on their life. Your life full of questions. God, why is this? You can ask God questions, but you are not familiar to question God. It's a two-word. God, why is this thing not working? Not God. God, why me? I'm all the people. Why did they do it? No. So now you expect it to happen to you. Hallelujah. When your joy is full, you are close to miracle, and miracle will happen to you. Joel chapter 1. Book of Joel, chapter 1, verse 12. Well, I may just speak on this one and close. Joel chapter 1, verse 12. I give myself some time for that 20, 25 minutes to finish the message. Joel chapter 1, verse 12. Joel chapter 1, verse 12. Yes. Technical, give me book of Joel chapter 1, verse 12. The wine is dried up. Please understand something here. The wine is dried up. And the fig tree languishes. The pomegranate tree, the palm tree also, and the apple tree, even all the trees of the field, will wither. Not before that, they come to. Because joy is withdrawn. I mean, God is withered away from sons of men. Put it there. Let it be made there. Technically, you are making noise. Everybody, please open your Bible or pass your hand on the tree. So when I say where God is lagging on the rocks, look at this. What are we saying? The wine is dried up. The fig tree languishes. And the pomegranate tree. The palm tree also, and the apple tree, even all the trees of the field. Every tree that can yield fruits, every tree that can bring harvest, every tree they can get food and sell, because they are well farmer, more or less farmer. The Bible says everything got dry because joy is withered away from the Son of Man. In a place where God is lacking, everything is dry. Physically, you are dry. Spiritually, you are dry. If you can't grow better, you ask people, question, why are you drying? Because you're dating. Hello? You will emaciate. You will know. You may be doing something that you are there as if you are 45. What happened? The person is dying. And physically, the person is dying. Spiritually, the person is dying. So everything on the field withered. Why? God is withered. One of the things that you must guide, you must not allow Satan to take, is the joy of the Lord. Anywhere you are joyful, as long as you keep enjoying the joy of God, you will keep refreshing. There is nothing that can happen to a man after salvation is a peace of mind, not money. You can be wealthy without having peace. You will die shortly. And the money cannot save you. A lot of millionaires are living based on drugs. And after some time, they see that. With the same sickness they were trying to maintain, I prophesy in your life. The joy of the Lord will overwhelm you. Very good. Where joy is lacking, nothing works. When a wife is thinking and full of problems and you are not giving, he may not be pregnant. But the womb will redeem Satan's house. Everything is right. When you overthink and go to bed, bad dream is guaranteed. Hello? Bad dream is what? You will get back here. If you like, pray like Jackie. Satan can understand some languages, if not all. With the language of the Spirit, Satan, you can maneuver Satan with that. So he knows where to touch to break people down. And one of the things is God. Don't allow Satan to touch your door. Never you allow anything to take joy away from you. Nothing will. You will not receive communication from the Spirit. It is then you will be asking yourself a question. Is God not answering me? It's because you are dried of God. In heaven, no second for sober reflection. They are always full of joy here. Don't allow your joy to be taken from you. Please avenge of him. Where you are not joyful, you will not lack the right word to use. You will lack the right word to use in prayer. Because you want, okay, you wake up, you want to pray, you are confused. But the heart is very heavy. The heart is full of prayers. You are struggling to pray and you are struggling to sleep. Am I correct? Has that happened to anyone here? You are struggling to pray and you are struggling to sleep. Okay, pray and one God come in one sleep. You can't sleep, just be rolling. Be rolling. Be rolling. Anything you do in God, you do it. You anytime you are full of God, you will sleep well. You don't need sleeping tablets. Because everything good work where joy of God is present. Am I speaking to someone here?
Yes, sir.
He said, they are wine dry. They are apple tree dry. They are already everything on the feet got dry. He said, because the Son of Man is withered away from joy. Hallelujah. The same verse, chapter 1, 16 to 17. Technical, please don't do us that. Same verse, chapter 1, read verse 12. Then let's move to verse 16 and 17. Thank you. He said, is it not the meat cut off before our hearts? What cut off? Remember. What cut off? Before we hear. He said, yea, joy and gladness before the house of God. Verse 17. The seed is rotting under their clothes. The gallows are laid desolate. The barns are broken down. For the corn is withered. Now, let me read from NIV. You can see how devious what Satan is doing. Somebody said, Dr. Luke has said, if you say Satan you are powerless, you say you agree with him. But when you say Satan you are stupid, you say you don't agree. Hallelujah. The when you say Satan you are not wise, you say you don't agree. Why is Satan capturing many people? It's wisdom. Hello? He lured you. When you see a giant fall, he didn't fall one day. Am I speaking to somebody?
Yes, sir.
Satan know how to draw his tactics. He know how to draw his snare and know the way to follow. Hallelujah. Look at it here. He said, the day, okay, our food disappeared before our very eyes, their food. Why? He said, no joyful celebration are held in the house of our God. Their food, God disappeared. Why? No joyful celebration in the house of the Lord. It is very good for the church of God to rejoice anytime we find ourselves in God's presence. It's a platform to connect with the source of blessing. Praise God. Am I speaking to someone here?
Yes, sir.
Are we together?
Yes, sir.
Say, we see, that is verse 7. Say, we see, die in the pasture ground, and their grain crops fail. The barns stand empty, and the greeneries are abandoned. Why? There is no joy in the house of the Lord. And if you want to teach theologically, what is the joy that God is talking about? Not unto the gather, unto the part of it. You are God's temple. So if there's no joy inside of your house, you give no room for Holy Spirit to operate. Because Holy Spirit operates in the realms of God. You don't pray to be happy because happiness means happy. But what happened that gives you joy when it disappears with the soul? Joy is a permanent thing. So allow the joy to come. That's how does it possible? Refuse to be willing. If you are connected and you keep focus, understand what you are looking for and know how to get it. should be your concern. If people have gotten it by the scripture, you will get to hope. But there are spirits that God gave us. Willingness is not among them. Heaven gave us the spirit of the word. It gave us the spirit of love. It gave us the gift of the Holy Spirit. And it gave us the spirit of joy and peace of mind. When all these things are highly registered in your mind, you are taking Satan out of your way. Walking in love, it means walking in God. So when you are the carrier of Holy Spirit, you are led and protected. Where God and peace of mind is speaking, you can't die prematurely. And everything works out for you. I'm not speaking to someone here.
Yes, sir.
Any example you write in God, you will pass.
Amen.
It's not a prayer point. Deviate from crowning. You don't want to look good. Hello? Job. 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 The Lord bless you.
Amen.
How to get this kind of job? Number one, only in God's presence. Only in God's presence. You get job only in God's presence. Psalm 16:11 and Luke 1:44. Psalm 16:11 and Luke 1:44. Psalm 16:11 and Luke 1:44. So give me first Psalm 16:11. Okay, we are rounding up now. Yes. Now it's only the path of life. In the present is fullness of joy, and at the right hand there are pleasure of what? Forever. In thy presence is fullness of joy. You get joy only in God's presence. If it is outside God, it's happiness. That was again, happiness simply means happening. Happening. Something happened to you, hey, you can be thinking now, and then your friend just told you, hey, go take a car. You have to do something more. Hey, go to please, go to please. I mean, you have to go, where are you now? Hey, let's watch it. You come the wine. You come back home because the event is up. Take it off. Am I correct? Hello. So why? Because what happens leads to the happiness. So happiness simply means the happiness. So don't be ruled by what is happening around you. Establish the joy of God. Stronger than happiness. And how can you do that? Psalm 16:11. In the presence of God, there is a fullness of joy. By you allowing the spirit of the Lord to flow. The joy inside of this. Luke chapter 1, verse 34. Luke 1:44. Is it there yet? Luke 1:44, yes? When I'm there. Luke 1:44. For lo, as soon as the voice of the salutation sounded in my heart, the baby leaped in my womb for joy. The presence of the baby Jesus in the womb. This is that Elizabeth baby John. And the presence, see that the joy in the baby, live for joy. Oh, God's presence. The God presence is powerful more than anything you can compare it with. In his presence, you get security. But it's only one that wants over you. Look at what he said. He said, except the God watch over the city, the watchman protecting it. Every testimony you are hearing by God's presence. You can be in your house and collect. You can be in the church and collect. You can be in the church and you may not be in the church. It happened by the intimacy, the center of your mind. I do see a lot of people in the church and God, they go with nothing. But your mind is not even in anything they are doing. You are here, but you are not here. You can't get anything. It is difficult to come to the church and you allow your spirit to be traveling. Only you remember the food at home, only you remember the death, you only remember that you have to travel, you are just remembering and remembering and remembering. Satan is driving your vehicle. You have to pay. Stop. I am in God's presence. It takes presence of God to carry his presence. It is the presence of God that raises a presence of God. So if you are not carrier of his presence, you cannot carry his presence. And your joy cannot be overflow. The presence of Jesus coming in the womb and the baby in the womb, there is a connection in the spirit, because the Bible says the fire of the Elijah will go. So somebody must be here with. Because there's a connection from heaven already. So see themselves, there is an assurance of God. Now, if you know, one of the ways you are praying for future partner, one of the ways to know that this person is like present, the joy of the man, you will live in God. And immediately the God is registered, peace will be confirmed. Any business you are going to do, God communicate via your mind. One of the signs God communicate with you. Are you ready? I'm saying now. And as soon as you want to lay your hand and you discover that joy disappears, it's an effort. You don't need to prophet to prophesy. You can't do it and get breakthrough. Because the joy in you is not confirmed. So you go for that. Death will come upon you. A very serious soul. Somebody give God glory. Please learn this one today. You gain nothing. Avoid worries. It's a weapon in the hands of Satan. And finally, note, authenticity of God is not guaranteed without Jesus. Your God is not authentic and it's not guaranteed without Jesus. Meaning, you must give your life to Jesus genuinely because he died for you. Matthew 11:28. Come unto me, all ye that labor and have living, and I will give you rest. So you must call to him. You must come to him. There is something that is bothering you. You want to try to get the joy. This is that's why I say it's not happiness. You can't create it. Hello? You can create happiness by playing game. Watching comedy. So you'll be like, don't forget to sleep. The joy will come because by God present alone is not creatable. Please understand. God is very good, but only in his presence. You have nowhere to run to when you run outside God. If you run out of Jesus, you are running to damnation. But God speaking to someone here.
Yes, sir.
Say, come unto me, all ye that labor and heavy laden. You are full of problems. Up and down, challenges of the world. Nothing seems to work. Jesus said, it's going to work if you come unto me. Can you see now it's a choice? Hello? Is that not a choice? Come unto me. You come. You take decision to return to Jesus. If you want God. If you want to be free from Satan, you must come to Jesus. It's not negotiable. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Jesus died for you so that you will not die. Jesus died for you so that you can have that joy. The joy that Satan has taken away, Jesus comes to restore. He died for all, he restored the joy. But you will be entitled to that joy, that kind of joy, when you come to him. When you come to him, you discover that things will start working. When your joy is activated, the Lord bless you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
make it a decision today and take a bold step of faith and return to God. Return to God. You can't get joy elsewhere. Lie. You can't get it anywhere. You can't get it anywhere. That something is working for you does not mean that you are no better. Call unto me. Oh yeah! I'm having nothing. And I will give you rest. Joy guarantee rest of mind. And the rest of mind is in Jesus. Come to Jesus, you will see peace coming because you can't create it. You don't know how it's happening. You just sit down. Just happen. When you do the will of God, God do your will. Let's know how you do it so bad. The Lord bless you. In the name of Jesus, come to your feet. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Of unstoppable greatness.